Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Gboyega Adedeji, and I welcome you to today's edition of Forms and Patterns. How has the week been? I hope it has been great. Bless God for that. Thank you for sharing your time with us, sharing your data, your resources to be part of this live broadcast. My prayer is that God, who has given you that provision, who has given you the willingness, the heart to be part of this broadcast, is going to richly bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, it has been a great journey together for the last few weeks, going through recovering your dominion. The Holy Spirit has been taking us through the process. He has exposed us to understanding the divine plan. He has begun the journey by helping us to know that there is a grand plan of God for dominion for everyone. And it is not just for the church as a whole, but for individual members of the body of Christ. So if you are a man and you are called into the ministry, you do not assume that the blessing of God, the wisdom of God, the power of God is only available for your church or for your ministry. It is available for everyone that is born of God through Christ Jesus. So by divine plan, there is dominion for everybody. And we understand how the devil came into the game, into the whole thing, and how he snatched dominion from her. And so there was a need for man to be brought back to the place of dominion, and that was the reason for the emergence of Jesus Christ. So Jesus came to restore us back to our place. We had the dominion, and we were introduced to the real words. We were told that there, in the dictionary of God, there are words that begins with R-E. They are the real words of God. So the words like revive, repent, recover, restore, revive, and all manner of real words. And we also looked at how manufacturers also love that real word. So they mention replacement of parts, they mention repairs. Should there be a problem along the way, so they return, they ask you to reset, they ask you to return. There are matters about production, there are matters about creation that involves the reward. And so we were exposed at the beginning of this series to the rewards and the essence of them. So it is important for us to know that we began as a people in dominion. The devil came to take us out of that place, and we are expected to return back to our places of authority, back to our domains of influence, back to our territories of authority. And so we were exposed to the divine plan of God. And you mustn't forget, God has not changed his mind. And there's a scripture that came very quickly to my mind in the book of Isaiah. And I want us to quickly check it, so that we will know that God is not a man that he should lie, but the son of man that should repent. God doesn't plan a thing and suddenly change it. Now let's quickly see Isaiah chapter 46 and from verse 10. We'll read to verse 11. It says, declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand. Do you understand that saying? My counsel. Another word for that counsel is my plan. What I have proposed to do, it will stand in spite and despite of anything or any circumstance. What I have proposed to do concerning you, your life, concerning mankind, will stand. Whether the devil comes in or the devil does not come in, what I propose to do will stand. You see, a man can only delay the timing, but a man cannot stop the happening of a thing. You can only say, oh, the timing, I want to take it backward or take it forward. You can struggle with that. But whether what God has purposed will come to pass in your life, in your generation, it is not in doubt. It is in time. It says, calling a bird of prey from the east, the man who executes my counsel from a far country, indeed I have spoken it. Not that word, indeed I have spoken it. and I will bring it to pass. I have proposed it, I will also do it. I have spoken it, I will bring it to pass. I, the Lord, will bring it to pass, not you. I will bring it to pass. Your dominion is my responsibility. I, the Lord, have proposed to put you in your place of authority. You could be showing some attitude that does not show a man who is in honor, but I will take you back to your place. Some people could love captivity so much that they do not want to return back to their place of glory. They do not want to return back to the place of freedom. But yet, when the time comes for a people to be returned back to their places, then the scripture says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of his people, we were like them that dream. Turn again our captivity, O Lord. God is able to turn again the captivity of a people. God is able to restore a people. God is able to take a people back to their original state. Whether the people really want it or not, it's a matter of time. The purpose of God over your life will stand. But God will also not do it against your will. So he will help you to will it. And so the scripture says, it is God that works in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. So God works in you to will it. God works in you to do it. And the Bible says, as God said, I have proposed it. He says, I've spoken it, I will bring it to pass. I've proposed it, I will also do it. So we know the divine plan will not be changed for anything. You could be showing an unwillingness to rule in your world. You could be showing an attitude that does not depict readiness to rule in the affairs of your nation, to rule in the affairs of your life. But God is able to work in you to will it and to do it. And that's my prayer for you. You know, as we are stepping into this dominion, it is not expected to be at the realm of knowledge. It is expected to be at the realm of experience. Don't just know the truth, be free by the reason of that truth. Be set free, be established by the truth. It is not enough to know, you must be able to apply your knowledge. It is not enough to know, you must be able to apply your knowledge. It is not enough to know you can be free. It is important for you to fight for your freedom. You see, being aware that there is a plan of God for your restoration in dominion, it's important, but it is not enough. And so a man must be exposed to the assignment of God for his life. A man must be exposed to the assignment of God for his life. There is no man that has no assignment from God. You see, have you ever seen a man that you ask, what is your name? And he says, I am a nameless man. Have you ever seen a nameless man? Every man has a name assigned to him or her on this earth. If the human parents are able to give you names, don't you think God has a name he has called you? That is why it is important for everyone to seek for the understanding of the name that God calls him or her. It is in your name that your authority is. It is in your name that your relevance is. Your name is a picture, is a description of your assignment from God. And you must find out that name. So it's important to know that even though man was in honor, but man did not remain, but you are expected to return back to that place of honor in your own living, in your own lifetime. And so you begin a journey of returning back through understanding the assignment of God for your life. And so a man who has settled the matter of God's assignment for his life, who is now aware of it, must then move into the realm of understanding the making of God over his life. You see, God does not use a man he has not made. If I may put it in another way, if you are a potter, and what you do is to make vessels. You make vessels of different sizes. And should you need to eat food in your house or to drink water, would you go out looking for vessels to use, or would you use what you have made? I'm sure you will use the one that you made, because you can be sure that what you have made, what you've committed your efforts to,
is able to hold water without leaking it. Is able to carry food without breaking, because you understand the quality of what you have made. You see, unlike people in Nigeria or in some places in Africa, when you see Germans or you see Americans in a different country, they don't seek for vehicles made by different countries. No, they drive the vehicles made by their country. And so if a German man is in Nigeria, he has a big business, you will see him drive Mercedes, you will see him drive cars, vehicles made by the German people. That is the same way Americans behave. They will rather buy a Ford product or a Chrysler, they will, or a Chevrolet, they will buy a product made by the Americans. They can trust it and they know it has value, it has quality, and so they trust it. It is expected that manufacturers and people that think like manufacturers, they use the things they produce. God is the greatest manufacturer. He does not use what he has not produced. He does not consume what he has not made. He does not engage what he has not made. So if you want God to engage you, you want God to make, you want God to use you, you must allow God to make you. God does not import men. God does not import vessels. God manufactures his own vessel. God makes his own vessel. Amen. God makes his own vessels. You want God to use you? Allow him to make you. So it's important to know there's a plan of God for your life and destiny. And for us to know that even though the plan of God for our lives is real, there is also a name that has been assigned unto us. There is a responsibility that has been tacked by our names or with our names that is as real as the plan of God for our lives. And a man who has settled the matter of God's plan, God's assignment for his life, must launch quickly into the realm of divine making, submitting himself, submitting herself to be made by God. You see that song that says, "Take me, break me, mold me, and use me, Lord." You remember that song? "My life is a sacrifice for you." Now, let us not go there before you start examining and analyzing my capacity to sing. Hallelujah. Now, you remember that song? It begins with God taking you. It begins with God breaking you, molding you, and using you. You see, a life that is not available to be broken by God, a life that God cannot take, break, and mold, then God cannot use. And so, a man who has settled that is a man who is willing, a man who is ready, a man who is qualified for the backing of God. You see, it is not enough to preach in the name of God. It is not enough to pray in the name of God. You must have the right to do it. And we remember that story in the book of Acts of the Apostles about the seven sons of Sceva who went around. What they were skilled in doing, what they were doing as professionals, was actually casting out demons. So how did they do it? They have the demonic powers to cast out demons from other people. They use the power of demons to cast out demons. Now, when they saw Peter casting out demons, not with the same power that they used to have, but with a different power, they came and they didn't just even come to them. They also took it upon themselves. They saw Apostle Paul, they took it upon themselves and they started casting out demons. And they say to the demonic possessed people, they said, "We cast out, we exorcise you in the name of Jesus that Apostle Paul preaches." And the demon said, "Jesus I know, Paul I know, who are you?" Now that is a matter of authority. It's not enough to have a capacity. You must have an authority. It is not enough to have the money to get things done. You must have a legal backing behind you. Otherwise, you'll be arrested. And these seven sons of Sceva were arrested by the demon. And the demon-possessed man leaped on the seven people and tore their clothes. So they ran out of that house beaten and naked by one demon-possessed man. One demon-possessed man arrested seven people. That is how life The little things of life can arrest people in life, in destiny, simply because they have not been authorized to do the things they go about doing. It is not enough for you to know there is a need to be met, a job to be done. You must be given the right to get that job done. And that is what authorizes you, and that's the basis of your authority. So a man who knows the plan of God for his life, a man who has understood the assignment that God has for him or her, a man who has entered the realm of being submissive to the divine making of God, a man who has done that is a man who is qualified to be given the authority of God. When the disciples have stayed with Jesus for a while, the Bible says Jesus called them together and he gave them power over demons, to cast out demons. And when they returned, they said, in your name we cast out demons. We did this. And Jesus said, do not rejoice that you are casting out demons, because these are little matters. Do not rejoice with these signs, wonders that you saw. Rather, rejoice because your names are written in heaven. Now, rejoice because you are still an authorized dealer of God's power on the earth. Rejoice because you are still a son of God, and the heaven has not denied who you are. You see, some people go around trying to represent God, and yet some God is wondering, who has called these people? Who has sent these people? It is not enough to have a passion. You must be authorized to practice what you are passionate about. You can't sleep and wake up one day and call yourself a medical doctor. You must go through the medical training and become a licensed, a man that is certified, a certified surgeon, a certified practitioner. You must be certified, and it is God that does that. And so a man who has not concluded the making process can never experience the authority of God behind him. And so, having gone through that, it is important for a man to launch and to be launched into the realm of divine power. You see, it is okay to be made. It is great to be authorized to do things, but you need what you need. What you need to use, you need it. There are tools that are important, that are required for you to be in dominion and for you to sustain your dominion. There are tools that you need, and those are the things that the Holy Spirit took us through when we were looking at understanding divine power. While there is a spirit of dominion, there are gifts of dominion. A man who has the spirit also requires the gift. And so we saw in Revelation chapter 5 verse 12 that the scripture says, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power, riches, honor, strength, blessing, and glory. And we said the things that he was slain to receive were not the things that he lacked as a person, but the things that we needed to have access to through him. So he was slain to receive them so that he might give them to us. And the scripture says in John chapter 1 verse 12, for as many that has received him, to them he has given power, he has given rights to become sons of God, children of God, even to them who believe in his name. You see, as Jesus had a name, and that name Jesus is a description of his assignment on the earth, you also have a name. And so if you believe in the name of Jesus, you believe in the purpose of Jesus on the earth, you are, by the reason of your belief, been given the right to become children of God. Because you become a son through Jesus. Do you understand that? And so we know that for a man to be in dominion and remain and really be effective in dominion, the man requires these things that Jesus was meant to receive. You can't be free if you lack the financial resources. You can't be free if you lack honor. You can't be in dominion if you lack power. To be in dominion, you must be a man of strength. So all these things Jesus was slain to receive, it is that you might use them, you might engage them for your own relevance and influence on the earth. I pray that God will help us and bless us in Jesus' name. You see, a man who has allowed God to have his way. Don't forget, in Isaiah that we read, Isaiah 46, 11, the scripture says, calling a bird of prey from the east, the person who executes my plan, my counsel, my purpose, from a far country, indeed I have spoken it, I will also bring it to pass. I'll bring it to pass. I've proposed it, I will also do it. Now, I do not know the calling of God on your life. I do not know how He called you and when He called you. But one thing I know is that the will of God is done on the earth through men and women that respond to the call of God over them. You must respond and you must settle down to be made. You must respond to His call and you must settle down to be made. You must respond to the call and you must settle down to be made into a suited vessel for that assignment. You see, the making of God on our lives differs with different people. You see, the way God makes me is different from the way God will make you. But you must settle down to be made by the Lord Jesus Christ. You must be made. You see, even though you could have many vessels in your house, they are hardly the same. What is the point when your house is filled with the same vessels? Can you sit with all of them, eat with all of them, drink with all of them, and sleep on all of them? No. Some will be for sleeping, some will be for sitting, some will be for eating, some will be for drinking, some will be for different things. And so, as a house has different vessels, so are men and women called by Jesus made into different vessels in the kingdom. I do not know the vessel that God is making you, but I believe He's making you. If only you are continually willing to be submissive to His will, you must remain submissive. You see, it is not enough to say, Lord, make me. You must be able to tell the Lord, anything you want to make me, you are free. Anyone you want to make me, you are free. Please make me the way you like. Make me to become who you want me to become. You cannot determine to God who you want God to make you. You cannot tell God how you want Him to make you. It is Him that holds that prerogative. It is the potter that makes the clay the way He wants it to be made. And God who made you is able to remake you if only you bring yourself to Him. My prayer is that you will not struggle to submit yourself to your Master, and you will embrace His workings within and workings upon your life. Because it is until He has made you, it is until He has worked thoroughly on you, that you are presentable and you are ready to be showcased by Him. You are ready to be showcased by Him. There's a scripture I want us to read, if I'm able to find it. In the book of Malachi. Malachi chapter 3, as we are concluding now. Malachi chapter 3, I will read from verse 2. Malachi 3 verse 2, it says, but who can endure the day of His coming? And who can stand when He appears? For He is like a refiner's fire, and like launderer's soap. He will sit as a refiner and a purifier of silver. He will purify the sons of Levi and purge them as gold and silver, that they may offer to the Lord an offering in righteousness. That's the Lord God. That's what the Lord does. The Lord loves to sit as a refiner's fire and as a launderer's soap. He loves to refine us. He loves to purify us. And see the people God is talking to. He's talking to the sons of Levi, men and women called to be priests. Have you been called into the pastoral ministry? Have you been called into any form of ministry? Then you must allow God to sit on you as a refiner's fire and as a launderer's soap. You see, when a silver or a gold is refined, it becomes a different entity. An entity not to be pitied, an entity to be envied. If you want people to envy your life and destiny, then allow God to sit on you as a refiner's fire. Allow God to be to you as a launderer's soap. Let Him make you clean. Let Him purify you. Let Him purge you. Let Him refine you. Until God is done with you with that, you are not ready to be showcased. You are not ready. Readiness for showcase, readiness for manifestation, readiness for demonstration of God's power, God's wisdom, God's authority on the earth. It is by the making of God on a man. And so as you launch out, as you step out in dominion, as you go about exercising your authority, as you manifest the glory of God in your life without hindrance, without limitation, you remember that song that says, no limits, no boundaries. As you go about being limitless, as you go about expanding the frontiers of God's kingdom on the earth, you must always remember that your authority is sourced in your making. And the day you stop being made by God, you stop being showcased by God. The day you stop being made by God, you stop being demonstrated, you stop being manifested by God. You remember the scripture that says in 1 Corinthians that the manifestation of the Spirit is for the profit of all. It is not for your glory. The authority is not for your glory. The riches is not for your glory. The blessing is not for your glory. The power, the strength, the honor is not for your glory. The scripture says no man has received this honor unto himself. It is God that makes you. It is God that has put you there. And it must be for his glory that you reign. It must be by him you reign and for him you reign. And we must always keep that in our heart. Don't stop glorifying God with your life. Don't stop submitting yourself to his will. Don't stop being made by God. Every time you appear before God, allow the word of God to reign supreme over your life. Let your life be configured and be reconfigured and be transfigured by the word of God. Don't have an appearance that is permanently outside the control of the word of God. Allow the word of God to have such an authority over your life that can remake and remake and remake your life again and again and again until you become perfect. Remember the scripture that says, the path of the just is as of a shining light that shines brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. There is a perfect day ahead of you. But before then, you must keep shining. You must keep shining. You must keep shining. And the secret is to continually be refined by the Lord God. Allow God to continually refine you. Don't be tired of his walking. Don't be tired of his laundering activity. Don't be tired of his refining job over your life. Allow your life to perpetually be refined by him. And let the brightness of your life keep shining. Don't forget that the scripture that says in Isaiah chapter 60, arise and shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. It says, behold, Gentiles shall come to your light and kings to the brightness of your shining. It is not enough to shine for a season. You must perpetually shine. Your shining, your brightness must be as of an increasing light that increases unto the perfect day. It is not enough to be celebrated once. You must remain a man, a woman that is perpetually celebrated because of the quality of output that your life releases in the hand of God. My prayer and my desire that you also go more before God to pray over this matter. You must perpetually be in that posture of prayer, communicating with God that, Lord, continue to make me. Do not stop your work in my life. Make me a man in progress, a work in progress in your hand. A man that you are always working on, making better, perfectly on a daily basis. A man who goes around doing good, healing all that are oppressed by the devil, for God is with him. What is God doing with you? Is God just playing around your life, or is God really working on your life? God is with you, and God must be with you. As long as he's with you, he must be with you as a refiner's fire and as a launderer's soap, so that he can purge you and that you might offer unto God an offering in righteousness, so that your ministry can be a ministry of righteousness and the name of God be magnified on the earth. Thank you for this gift of your time. It has been such a moment in the hand of God. It has been such a moment together as God's people on the earth. It has been a moment to be refreshed for ministry and in ministry. This is forms and patterns, a place where ministers and ministries are challenged, are edified, and are equipped for effective ministry on the earth. My name is Gboyega Adedeji. It has been a joy bringing this word to you. I pray that God will help you to remain true to the call over your life and the call over your destiny. Stay blessed.
and keep in touch with the Master. Hallelujah. Amen.